we begin our journey, leaving the city of Buenos Aires, getting further and further away from the hustle and bustle of the city. The rain clouds hang heavy overhead as the storm pours down with thunder and lightning. But we push through. We need to make it to our destination.
So, we've started our journey and we are 2 hours away from Córdoba. So far, so good. We stopped and had some fish in Rosario. And I can't wait to get there. Can't wait to see my family that's coming to visit from LA. They should be arriving tomorrow. My dad is driving. He's doing a good job. Thanks for driving, Dad. And yeah, good trip so far.
As we drive through the night, I stare out the window and look into the darkness and wonder, could there be something more out there? Could there be something behind the veil that we don't see?
So I'm on my cousin's roof right now. There's a beautiful view up here. It's a bit windy. I didn't film when we got here last night because we got here super late. So it's day two and my family from Los Angeles has arrived and I feel great. I'm happy to see all them. And I think this is gonna be a good adventure and I'm gonna document this whole experience. So I'm gonna take you guys with me and hopefully we can make it to Capilla del Monte. The thing about Córdoba is that it has this mystical vibe to it. There's a lot of legends and stories about this place and I wanna see if any of them are true. So we decided to come to the Alfajor Festival here in La Falda. Looks pretty cool. So if you've ever had an alfajor, you'll know that it's delicious. And it's probably one of the best snacks you can get here, sweet snacks you can get in Argentina. I just got a free chocolate, and try it out. It's good. Guys, look at this beautiful view. It's amazing. This is in La Falda, no? Seguimos, we're still in La Falda. Look at that behind me. You can see, I feel like Mufasa. It's amazing. When you're on top of places like this, it's like you can finally see how small we really are. And we're not even that high up.
Weird, look at it. It does look...
I can't see it.
Where's the
comment?
Now you're making
a
question.
It's very high.
Yeah, but where's the power? Nick,
where'd
you see a power line?
Come here. Look,
look at it.
You see it?
You see it?
It's,
it's
moving. No, it's moving.
It's going like this.
I'm just saying, I think there's...
Oh,
power
shit.
Power
that shit is moving.
This one.
Oh, he's saying from this.
Like this. There's a cord. There's
probably
a pole.
No, look. There's a cord here. Power.
Sí.
yo duermo casi en vos, ¿no?
Claro.
Y sentí.
Guys, I am in the Eden Hotel right now because supposedly paranormal things happen here. People see ghosts, and there's legends tied to this place.
Esto se está recuperando y no restaurando, ¿sí? Porque imagínense que hacer una restauración es muy costosa y prácticamente imposible, ¿sí? Ese sector era la sala de correspondencia, ¿sí?
It is what it is, Chris.
I'm gonna put my Instagram tag on there.
I'm gonna doubt you.
Why are you holding the pin like you're gonna snap your fucking fingers?
Just ruin this out.
The end of Gaucho. At the end of Gaucho.
So I was with the tour just a minute ago, and I got a little lost, but I think I see them. This is a crazy, crazy location. There's so much history here. You can feel it while you walk down the halls and stuff. I've actually been drinking beers with my cousins, which is probably not the smartest thing, and probably explains how I lost the tour, but it's kind of cool to be alone checking this out. So it's been about 2 days since we've been in Córdoba, and I've just been having fun with my family. We all are kind of believers in the high strangeness and this phenomenon, so I'm sure some great stories are going to come out of this. It might start raining, so I might need to change to the GoPro, because I'm afraid of what the water will do to this camera. Okay. There's like some Halloween cobwebs right here. Those are not even like real cobwebs. There's like some bats in here.
This is where you were right here, up here. It connects right here.
Oh, yeah. This is actually a trip. Huh?
This is amazing.
It's crazy, right?
Yeah. This has been here for so long. Like
so long. I mean, the crazy thing is like the history.
Yeah.
All the people that were in here walking around.
Yeah, there's literally people like.
Yeah. That's crazy.
Are you recording?
Yeah. What?
You're recording?
Yeah.
Let me go on.
No, stop. Well, Nick.
Sí.
Sí.
Está muy bien.
¿Está?
En Argentina, sí. Y nosotros, biblioteca.
Biblioteca.
Yeah, they both make me go back there.
They both stepped in shit last night. They
don't
got
make
the,
me.
They got on the camera like, why does it smell like shit? John's like, guys, I got a problem.
And all of a sudden, there's a, you know, in San Francisco, you got oncoming traffic and traffic going that way. And in the middle is a whole bunch of grass, tall grass. Out of the grass comes a big fucking white ball, just comes up, and it's an egg. The egg morphs, like fucking into three fucking eggs and a light.
He's lying.
And it goes back in it, and then it goes like this. Three fucking lights, big long lights, all white with three lights. This thing goes back to an egg with one light, and it fucking just takes off. It goes, pow! Fucking really far away. You can't even see the light again. You can't see the light anymore. And then the light starts coming. It gets bigger, and it fucking goes towards our car right in front of us. And I got a fucking convertible. Fucking beautiful convertible, just in case you don't know. 69 convertible, beautiful. Fucking, it goes right on top of us. We had to fucking pull out of the fucking freeway so the thing wouldn't crash into us. I looked backwards because I wanted to see the UFO, and everybody is like pulling on the side, going, what the hell? Going, what the hell's going on? Waiting for the thing to come back, and comes back and goes, and it just takes off. Like a big fucking light. Like in 1 second, it was just like, boom. That shit was crazy.
This is San Francisco, right?
San Francisco. Coming back from San Francisco.
What year was it?
This was 93.
You remember the month?
Huh?
You remember what month it was?
No.
Not at all?
It wasn't cold. It wasn't cold, so I can't. So I could say maybe July.
Yeah. Do you remember the highway?
The main one. There's only one to go into San Francisco.
Yeah.
To come in and out. It's only one.
Somewhere like July.
I think it's the one freeway, right?
1993, you said? Freeway.
He's trying to find a correlation to something else.
Yeah, no, it's the one freeway. This thing fucking morphed. I'm talking about this piece of plastic turning into a fucking ball.
Yeah.
Or whatever. This thing just fucking turned into some different just shapes. It's a shapeshifter. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's weird. I mean, from a ball, it went to a fucking three lights. From three lights, it went to a fucking one ball. No, this thing was, and then it turned, you know, when it came really close to us, it was a fucking egg.
It was egg shit.
Was everyone freaked out, or were you guys, like, excited?
Everyone was freaked out. Freaked out. But we had to get out of the freeway. Like, everybody pulled to the side because this thing was coming so low. So we all had to fucking, you know, shift it. I knew everybody was there. I wanted to stay there, but my friend was freaking the fuck out. He was crying. He was like, what the fuck was that? I'm, you know, let's go.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to leave my friend all hanging, you know?
Yeah.
Tricks are for kids. Silly rabbit. Yeah.
It's a beautiful day. The sun has finally come out. It's been raining for like 3 days. It's been cold, but the sun is out. Check this out. Look at that view behind me. It's beautiful.
Think about here, did landslides happen on these mountains?
Yeah, when it's raining. Probably.
I'd be so pissed. If all of a sudden, fucking tonight, there's another thunderstorm or something. It doesn't look like it. It's really clear. Yeah, no, it looks like it's gonna stay clear. Which is good. That would happen though. We get here and there's like a storm. Fucking coldest time in Córdoba for this season.
It feels so good though.
Right?
Ah.
Yeah, because we're not used to sun.
Finally.
I mean, we passed like the field right now.
Finally, 3 days of straight darkness and rain. We were like.
It really was. Sheer darkness.
Seriously.
Isn't that weird? It was like 30 days a night, but three.
No, it felt like a month of like just dark. It felt like a long time.
We sound like such bitches. We're like 3 days of darkness.
Jonathan, that was pretty. I need my vitamin D.
It was freezing.
And I'm really in it.
Really in it?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I don't know. Oh my goodness.
Made in China.
Made in China, really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
the world is deceiving. So, we are now in Los Cocos, and it's pretty cool. It's a nice location. There's like a lot of little shops and stuff. It's really sunny, so sorry about that if I'm super bright or something. I found a monster right away. Right away. But here, what you're going to want to do is come to this Complejo Errosilla. And that's gonna take you up here, all the way up the mountain. And at the top, there's like a bar and stuff. It's pretty cool.
Oh, look at this guy. This guy's in for trouble. There's a car coming. I don't like it.
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
What do you think about the name of this place, dude?
Alien.
No, it's Eileen. But I think it's...
No,
like
it's Eileen.
Totally, it's totally a play on words.
I don't know how you say that. It's A-I-L-E-N?
Yeah, Eileen.
That's not Eileen. Is it?
I'm not sure if this is a play on words, right? Like alien, Eileen, check this out. I don't know. I don't know.
Otra vez te veo hablando solo.
We are in Villa Giardino, and we're now in like the center of the city. And there's this long block here, like an avenue, filled with shops and places to eat. If you ever are in this area, I definitely suggest coming here because you'll be able to get, you know, beer or food or whatever you want. We're gonna have a burger and a beer here at this spot.
It's gotta be, dude. If that one's doing the same thing, unless we're seeing three fucking UFO rings.
Or did I just ruin everybody's party?
It's like Marino just pointed out that one that's doing the same thing.
I like that one. Yeah.
And the
no, it's not doing that much, the colors though. Yeah. That one's really doing colors.
Even if you squint.
Look at what Gummy got.
Fucking whole house full of people went blind.
Look at what Gummy got. Look at the colors.
It's happening right now. This is like...
No, squint really hard. Johnny.
Look at the colors. Look at the colors. Look at the colors.
It's a circle.
See, that's what people do.
It's a circle.
She's right. Look at the colors in the video.
That's not a star. It's a circle.
When you squint, it turns a solid color.
Really?
Yeah, squint and it turns a solid color. Yeah. It's just your eyes.
No, but it's blinking still.
Bueno, mira,
no, but I didn't
know. When I squint,
so we've made it to Capilla del Monte. I'm with my two cousins and we're going to hang out here. We're going to go get some food. It's gonna be a cool day. Check this out. UFO behind me. In my opinion, this location is like an X point. Everyone sees lights here. Many people have encounters here. I'm gonna check out the town after we eat, and we're gonna see what we can find.
Awesome.
Por favor, no bebas más, no llores. Por favor, yo te prometo, te esperaré. Si es que paras de correr.
Something interesting to consider is when I was looking at one of the statues earlier, a local walked by and said,
That's the last alien you'll see here in Capilla del Monte. You know, being here and seeing all these trinkets and all these aliens everywhere just reminds me that this phenomenon is global. This is something that happens all around the world to people from different walks of life.
And they got the lights and colors.
Yeah. Same thing we saw last night.
It looks like people come here in search of something. People are looking for the truth. And everywhere you go, there's photos of UFOs and orbs. And it's crazy to see in the middle of Argentina on the top of a mountain that this phenomenon reaches so far.
Español, muy poco.
Pero ustedes le pueden traducir.
Sí.
Decidieron quedarse.
La mitad se fueron y nos esperan en el piloto, nos quedamos por
aquí. Esa foto, ese retrato, eso es una pintura sí. Hecha por un pintor muy famoso en Barcelona, el señor Robert Gimós. Robert Gimós estuvo en uno de nuestros congresos. Contando su experiencia. Mm. Acá se las puedo contar en otra pintura
he
que él hace.
He was sharing his experience and he painted what he saw.
Oh, wow.
Por circunstancias personales está en Brasil. Decide ir a una zona de montaña sí. A hacer un esquema, un bosquejo. Y ve entre las nubes, hay una capa de nubes, y entre las nubes aparece esa nave, ese aparato. Ve eso, ve gente entre esas columnas que hay allí, ve gente caminando y le queda en su cabeza esta ventanita, es esa ventanita, son ellos. Wow. El color real que él los ve, yo estoy ahora en Barcelona conociendo toda su exposición y todo lo que él ha hecho, es marrón. Es un tono marrón como nuestra piel.
He said their skin tone that he remembers was brownish, kind of like our skin tone.
Acá lo que más se ven son luces de diferentes tamaños, colores, manifestaciones en diferentes horas del
what
día,
they see here the most
de la
is
noche.
Lights, different shades and stuff like that. But the shapes and stuff that she took here, they're more for like other parts of the world.
Has she seen lights?
¿Usted vio las luces acá?
Muchas. Luces de diferentes tamaños, en diferentes horas del día, de la noche, sí. El OVNI es más que una nave espacial o un platillo volador.
Sí.
En realidad, cuando estamos hablando de OVNIs, tú surcas toda una cantidad de contenidos que tienen que ver conmigo. Porque yo vivo en este planeta, tengo un cielo maravilloso donde allá hay un cosmos, donde allá hay otros hábitats y acá hay un hábitat maravilloso. Entonces, hablar de esto es mucho más que una nave espacial.
She said, I don't want this to be a thing of like a trademark.
Yeah.
Like McDonald's or this or that. There's so much more to OVNIs or
yeah.
Flying saucers that what people think.
Yeah.
We are all so connected to every living thing. So this is more beyond that.
Yeah.
Una imagen. Extraterrestre, una etiqueta tiene una imagen. Esto no es esa imagen, esto no es esa etiqueta, esto es mucho más. Es Ricardo Vilches, el de tu izquierda.
Uh-huh.
Ricardo Vilches, él acompañó muy de cerca un caso que para nosotros es muy importante, que es el caso de Enrique Castillo Rincón, costarricense que tuvo su experiencia en Colombia, subió a una nave, tuvo 9 horas con él, con ellos, y el contacto se extendió a casi 4 encuentros.
He studied the case, a very famous case from Colombia, forgot the name of the guy, who was taken to the spacecraft and spent 9 hours with them and came back and told his story and he studied the story and he was very...
¿Por qué? Porque Capilla del Monte hizo un antes y un después de la huella del pajarillo. Hasta el año 86, 400 personas subían a Cerro Uritorco por año. A partir del año 86, 100,000 personas comenzaron a subir el cerro por año y hoy sigue aumentando en cantidad, 200,000 por lo menos.
¿Y ven cosas acá?
Sí, 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 constantemente. Es un cielo como cualquier... ¿Ustedes son de?
Los Ángeles.
Miren el cielo en Los Ángeles. Sí. Esto no es un tema de Capilla del Monte. Los cielos hay que mirarlos. No importa que esté... A ellos no les importa si están contaminados, si hay nubes. Eso no es una condición para verlos o no verlos. ni el frío ni el calor. Nosotros seres humanos somos muy conflictivos mentalmente y ponemos muchos peros para hacer y para, en este caso, el tema ir a verlos. Capilla del Monte tiene un agregado único en el planeta, no lo tiene nadie, y es que esta olla hizo que todo el mundo se enterara que aquí había ovnis. Nada más.
This is what made Capilla del Monte so famous, because of this. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't mean that if you don't look anywhere else in the skies, anywhere else around the world, that you might not see.
Right.
It's just that this happened to be the one that was more prominent and people discovered it, so everyone started coming and coming. And yes, people still see it to this day.
Un dato importante, no porque sí la huella del pajarillo se hizo acá, ¿por qué no fue en Carlos Paz? ¿Por qué no fue en Los Ángeles? ¿Por qué fue aquí?
¿Por qué?
Ese ruiditorco, no tenemos respuestas, pero hay datos que nos sirven para ir entendiéndolo nada más, no hay una respuesta. Y este tema lo que tiene de interesante es que no tiene respuestas concluyentes. Cuando una persona concluye, está faltando la verdad, porque la verdad tiene más camino.
So it's my last day. I'm gonna have to leave tomorrow morning. I'm hanging out with Chris and my family. It's Mother's Day. And yeah, so far it's been a good trip. I got to see you and Nick and everybody.